Hey guys, so someone was recently asking me if you can use Smaart, the phase graph in Smaart, to compare to kick drum microphones and align them or basically see what they're doing and make judgments based on that. And this is the first time I've ever done it. I never tried it before, so I had to test it out. And so I'll show you how I set that up and sort of what I've learned so far. And if some of you are experts at this and you do this all the time, I hope you will comment on this video and let me know what I'm doing wrong or what you do instead. So let me close a couple of things here. I don't think I need this open. Maybe I need to leave this open. Okay, let me just make this window over here smaller so I don't have to look at it all the time. All right, cool. So let me show you what I've got. So over here in Logic, I'm playing two kick drum recordings. I've got a D12E and a Beta 91A, and I know you can't hear what that sounds like right now, so maybe after this I'll make two recording samples and I'll post this on the video so you can hear the samples. So here's what those microphones look like. We've got the AKG D12E and the Shure Beta 91A. I'm not sure how they're placed on this kick drum. This is a recording of a Counting Crows song that I got from some multi-track session from a long time ago. Anyway, probably the 91A is inside the drum somewhere and the D12E is outside the drum somewhere. But let's look at how we can start comparing these. So first of all, in Smaart, let's head over to the spectrum view. I'll hit play on this first guy. So this is the D12E. And this is the 91A. And let's put them in separate windows. I don't want to see this one. How can I stop that? I guess let's just look at them at the same window. And let's turn this down a little bit. Let's set this to like 3 seconds. Basically, I just want to compare, before I look at a two-channel measurement, I want to look at the single-channel measurement and see how these guys align. So I can see that around 110 hertz, they're at the same level. And both of them seem to have a pretty good boost and emphasis here, you know, around 117, 120. And then the Beta 91A, that's what it is, right? Yep. The Beta 91A seems to have gentler roll-off, at least back here. We've still got a lot of information here. And in the D12E, there's a big cut here and then another boost. And then kind of same thing up here. But let me just look at this low frequency information because all of this stuff up here is pretty low anyway. So that's pretty much all I can see with this single channel measurement is how these guys line up in level. But I know that where they match in level, hopefully I'll get summation in those areas as well. I guess that could be a creative question. So on the input side of things, a lot of times, we're looking at creative decisions and not necessarily scientific decisions, right? So it's where things get a little bit murky in this discussion, I guess, but those are the only first things I notice when I'm looking at these. Okay, here's how their frequency responses compare in the low end. So now let's look at the thing I was really interested in looking at, which is the transfer function. So I've got it set up so that in Logic, the D12E is the microphone signal and the Beta 91A is the reference signal. So I'm going to hit play on those. Cool. So first of all, I'm just super happy that this is working since this is one of the first times I've tried this. And we have a measurement here that we can look at and coherence is actually pretty good through here. So what information can I take away from this? Well, let me zoom in. So I'll go to my zoom preset one. Now I'm just looking at like 30 hertz to, what is this, 400? And this is hard for me to understand, I gotta tell you guys, because I'm used to measuring a reference signal like, you know, pink noise coming out of the generator here to my measurement signal in the room. They should be exactly the same in some regards. But this, I'm looking at two different microphones, but the same source signal. So what's happening here? I think it can help to review the user's manual here, just a couple of lines. So this line here, if there is an overall level difference between the two signals, the center line of the measurement moves up or down on the graph. If the reference and measurement signals are identical in level at all frequencies, the magnitude trace is a flat line. Okay, so I obviously don't have a flat line, but I can say in magnitude that where I have a measurement of 0 dB, that's where they meet an equal level. So what does this say? 85 hertz and 106 hertz? So I wonder if I can go back to my single channel measurements and compare that. Let's find 85 hertz. Yeah, it looks like they're matching in level there. And what did I say, 106? Yeah, and they're matching level there. Okay, so that makes sense to me. That's why we have 0 dB here, here, and I guess up here. And it's hard to tell exactly what's happening in here because of our low coherence. But initially what I'm thinking is, okay, in places where we have matching level, we probably also want matching phase. Now, what's going on in the phase here? I'm going to rotate this around a little bit. Let's go back to the manual as well and see what we can learn about the phase graph. Okay. So phase is a measure of the relative time relationships between two signals as a function of frequency. The slope of the phase trace is flat when the reference and measurement signals for the transfer function are identical and arrive at exactly the same time. So what is flat? We don't actually see anything perfectly flat here, but Chris Tangeris from Rational Acoustics has been helping me look at this, and he was explaining to me that he considers this area in here to be flat. So let's draw a line and say, hey, this area in here is flat. Why? Because it slopes this way. So that stuff's arriving late, and then it slopes this way. So that stuff is arriving early. So anything in between there is arriving on time. So even though it doesn't look exactly flat, this is what's arriving on time. So now I'm thinking, okay, how can I match up the stuff that is arriving on time and the stuff that is also matched in level? Right now we've got this area arriving on time. Oops. And that's not exactly what I need. What I really need is kind of this stuff in this area to arrive on time. Okay. So let's see if we can make a change here. So let's go over to Logic, open up this delay, and let's add 1 millisecond. Oh wait, I forgot to save the trace. Zero. We'll save this. Okay, now let's add some delay. Reset the averages. Cool, so now we can see it's changed a little bit. That flat area is no longer exactly right there. We can say that, let's cut these. I think we could say that it's moved up here a little bit, right? All right, so let's keep going because it seems like we're kind of shifting it over to the left. 2 milliseconds, reset averages. Okay, so let's just delete this. So now we might say that we are now getting a flat area, potentially all the way through here. Let's say at least to here, right? Let's add one more millisecond and see what that does. I'm going to maybe rotate this around here. So see this, where this looks kind of crazy? Through here. I'm going to kind of ignore that because of this coherence here. Okay. And now I think that we can say that we've kind of got flat going on, at least through here, maybe all the way to here. So as you can tell, as I was making those changes, nothing was happening up here in the magnitude trace. So this is not summation. It's still just relative level differences. So I didn't make any changes to the relative level. If I were to come over here and turn this guy down 10 dB, reset averages, now we would see a change in the magnitude trace. Okay, so let's reset that. Okay, so I've changed where on time is in the phase graph here between these two microphones. I added some delay, and now on time is over here in this area, which is what I was going for since this is where we've got a closer match in level. Okay, I could also look at moving it down here or up there, but this is what I decided to go for. Okay, how can we tell if this has made an improvement? Okay, so over here in Logic, I also sent both of these signals to a summing bus, bus 1, and that's now coming into input 1. So before we look at that, let's turn off this delay. We'll go over to back to our spectrum view. Let's hide everything except for our sum. Here's the sum. I'm going to turn on the averaging really high. And let's just let that settle down. Now save that, and I'll call that no delay. Now let's come in here and turn that delay back on, my 3 millisecond delay. Let's reset the averaging. Cool, these colors are kind of hard to see. Let me change. Okay, blue is where we were. That was with no delay. And now orange is the changes we've made. Let me zoom in here, make this a little bit easier to look at. Okay. So in the area, where did we make our changes at? We're sort of flat between, let's say, 63 and 160. So now between 63 and 160, we have more summation. How much did we actually gain? So here we're at 50 dB, and here we're at 45. So we gained 5 dB of summation through this area where we made the phase more flat and made them both arrive in time at those frequencies. You can see that we lost some summation in this area, and if we sort of scroll to the right here, you can see it's not all gains. Cool. So this is all I've learned so far. If you guys do this on your normal setup procedures, I hope in the comments you'll let me know how you do that stuff. I don't know if I'd actually be doing this in the field because it seems to take a little bit of time. I would definitely do it with a recording, or if I was working on a show where, like, a play would be great. If you're on tour with a play and you're using basically the same setup every night, or I guess even a concert, any show that you're doing the same setup every night, this would be great, right? You could really compare your channels, see what time things are arriving, and choose at what frequency ranges you want to get summation. Maybe you don't want summation in some frequency ranges, you know? These are creative decisions, tonal decisions. But now I've kind of learned how you can do this in Smaart, and I hope this is helpful to you guys. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. All right, thanks.